to be sure to measure your pan, your oven, before you start on this, don't you?
Yeah.
Now this is at 400 degrees. How long does it cook this way?
30 minutes until the top is nicely browned.
Good. That's very nicely browned, isn't it? Step one. Okay.
Okay. Next, we add the marsala to this. And this is just about 3 cups in the bottle.
This isn't a cheap dish.
No. Well, but it goes a long way.
Oh, yes.
And the tomato. And at this point, I'm going to start the marsala going by turning on the burner.
It'll, these are plum bottles. You know.
Yes. If you can't get fresh ones, you can use canned.
Mm-hmm. More herbals.
More herbs. And if, you know, if thyme isn't available or you have a little rosemary that you want to use, people can do that as well. It doesn't have to be exact.
As long as you have something
nice. Okay, I'm going to tie
them up.
Because bay leaves, I don't know that people know this, but bay leaves can be very dangerous. If people swallow a whole bay leaf,
what happens?
It can cut.
Oh, cut down through your throat.
Yes,
oh,
or
that
wherever
would be
it
a nice death, wouldn't it?
So if you're using bay leaves freely, you should count them before you put them in, so that when you remove them, you know how many you're moving.
Oh,
and we're turning
these up. About that.
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. So we know we're putting 4 bay leaves, some other things in there. And it's just started to boil. So
what
I'll add
here?
Chicken stock. This is browned chicken stock, which gives it this beautiful color.
Mm-hmm.
The balls were browned, the vegetables were browned.
Go on.
While it was being made. The chicken stock should come just a third of the way up or so.
This is a real base, isn't it?
A real classical way. If there's too much liquid, I think that the veal just tends to...
It's not the same.
Yes.
Yeah.
You put the oil on right down next to...
If you had a mom's turkey roaster, you could use that.
Yes,
yeah.
You could.
Yeah.
But it's nice to have something with a tight-fitting lid.
Yeah. Well, you just have to make do.
Yeah.
And that's just plain, like a sheet pan, as you would call it.
Yeah.
You would call it a jelly roll pan.
This fits nicely. The veal will shrink a little bit, and this will settle down on top of the... And now this goes into the oven for 4 hours to braise. And over here, we have one that braised 4 hours. And at the very end, we took the top off.
So it would brown nicely again.
Right.
Smells awfully good.
Now, we'll take it out of the pan and let it cool a little bit, and then wrap it in the foil and refrigerate it overnight, and it will firm up nicely.
And the idea of this is... You could eat it now, but it would fall apart, you
see. Yes.
No. You want it to firm up overnight.
So that you can slice it. You could also let it just cool here in the pan as it is until you get to take it out. Over there. And some of the bones are already starting to fall off. It's so long. Okay, I'll just put this over. I don't think we would. We don't want to wrap this up right away.
No.
Put it in the fridge. We want to let it cool.
Really. Yeah. Not too bad now to eat now. I guess we'll have to wait.
Okay.
Now, you have all these. And the interesting that the vegetables are still look pretty good, don't they?
Mm-hmm. They'll be very sweet from the masala. Start by ladling it, because I think that it will splash. I'm going to pull out the garlic so we can squeeze it into the sauce. Is there any more in there? Or did we? We may have all gotten squished already.
Maybe.
Yeah, I think so. take these guys out. And they're so soft. And mm-hmm. garlic helps thicken a sauce without adding butter.
Yeah.
Get rid of this. People are so scared of garlic, and it's really can be very mild and mm-hmm. tender, and
it's very good for you.
Yes. So we can just let that simmer for a little while
mm-hmm.
until it's a little bit thicker. Here's the veal that's chilled overnight in the foil. So it's turned up nicely.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, here's some of the sauce collect, so you can see that it's nice and
The veal bowl, I guess.
Yeah. I'll put this lovely. Right in here.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is going to be fascinating. I'm going to see what happens here. I'll get that out of your way.
Now, what I do, because I'm from New England, is save these pieces of string and use them to tie the ribs back up again.
Well, I'll be interested to see that. That's real.
Well, it's actually just convenient,
yeah.
because you have them right here, so why not use them? See, each one is a length here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
At this point. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, the ribs don't march along in perfect alignment. They
mm-hmm.
they kind of fan out. So there is a little bit of adjustment that you have to do as you slice through
mm-hmm.
here.
Yes, I can see what you mean, that if it were hot, that it would fall apart.
Fall apart.
Well, that cuts very nicely.
Mm-hmm.
That's perfect. Good.
And
that's lovely, the way the stuffing looks.
And it's held together slightly like this. You'd want to tie them like this.
Oh, yes, I can see why it was the string.
Mm-hmm. It's just the right
length. And this is wonderful. There you see the pistachios and the peas
mm-hmm.
and the mortadella. That's great, I think. It's a very pretty stuffing.
And you can see that there really isn't all that much meat here.
No.
Looks like a lot, but so much of it is fat that gets
mm-hmm.
rendered off.
Rendered out.
You can put these right back in here. Like this. And then we can pour sauce.
Probably sauce with the nice bits of garlic.
Mm-hmm.
I love this. It's what I would call real food.
Mm-hmm. If you wouldn't mind opening the door, we
okay.
can put this into the oven.
You want it on broil?
I think on bake to start.
At about what? 350?
I would say 4. I think
400,
I'd
go to 400.
Okay.
Yeah. Ah, look at that! Strings and all. It looks delicious.
That's great.
It? Now this is ready to serve. It's warm.
Ready to serve.
Good.
We've made some polenta, which is, you said, also known as cornmeal mush.
Cornmeal mush. But this is made out of Italian cornmeal.
Which means it's nice and shiny.
Well, it's a coarser grind.
Mm-hmm. I think the mistake that people often make with polenta is they don't add enough water. If you don't add enough water, the cornmeal doesn't have anything to absorb, so it stays grainy, whereas this looks nice.
And it really needs about 40 minutes to cook, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's such a wonderful smell or aroma. What do we say for food? You don't say smell, do you?
Yeah, I think you can say smell.
Yeah. Mm.
But this is...
And that meat would be so beautiful and tender, full of flavor. It's really the old-fashioned way of cooking and braising. And just because it cooks for 4 hours doesn't mean that you're cooking it for 4 hours. That's what's nice about it, I think.
I think it's 20. I would just put the...
Well, there's a really pretty garnish, and that's nice.
And a contrast.
It's very pretty, though. There's such a lovely bright green. You said they really are only in season about 2-3 weeks, aren't they?
It's a very short season.
So delicious. Well, this is lovely. I say I like family style, and then when it's plated, then you really have to eat all that's on your plate. And when it comes this way, you can eat just what you want.
Yeah, I agree.
Jody, this is wonderful. This is real food. It's something I like a bit.
And it fills the house for the 4 hours that it's cooking with these wonderful smells that spill out of the neighborhood.
Oh, that's great. Well, thank you very much.
Julia's got the tastiest sight on the web. With searchable